Breeze Airways is not your typical airline. Rather than a normal hub-and-spoke operation, this unconventional carrier flies directly between cities, often smaller ones, on routes with little to no competition. Want to fly from Provo to San Bernardino, Akron to Norfolk, Long Island to New Orleans? They've got you covered. But what's it like on board this bizarre little airline? The only way to find out is to go for a flight. Let's take a look at the map. When Calcadon and I were long distance, we usually flew Delta or JetBlue's non-stop services between Boston and Pittsburgh to see each other. They were the only airlines to fly this route at the time, although Spirit has since joined them. Boston Logan is the primary airport for a big swath of New England, and while it was convenient for us since Calci lived nearby, it's not as convenient for people living to the south, who have to make the trek into Boston just to get on a flight. Enter Rhode Island TF Green Airport near Providence, a smaller airport placed more conveniently for many passengers. Like many smaller airports in smaller cities, this is where Breeze has set up a base of operations, and they fly from here to 17 destinations, including Pittsburgh. So in order to try this new airline at the end of one visit to my girlfriend, I would be heading south from Boston by commuter rail and bus before flying Breeze's evening flight to my home city, and I would have a Bostonian friend travel with me for the first bit of the journey.
So now to find our train, out the one exit that is open.
I'm strongly considering taking this exit.
Okay, now I want Auntie Anne's.
Alright, let's do it.
Since it was a Sunday, the commuter rail wasn't running all the way to Providence Airport, so we got off in downtown Providence.
So I'm actually really excited to go to Providence because I'll be able to visit my alma mater, University of Providence.
From here, we caught a RIPTA bus to the airport. After saying goodbye to Miles, I headed to the small but inviting terminal building.
So I'm in line for baggage drop-off, but there's nobody taking bags. It's about just over 2 hours before the flight. So that is points off right there.
Thankfully, the baggage counter opened up just moments later, and I was able to successfully check my bag. I paid for a carry-on bag, but they let me check it instead for no extra charge. Security was an absolute breeze. Wow, I didn't realize what I did there, and I wound up with a lot of time to kill. Providence Airport, officially Rhode Island TF Green International Airport, is served by most major US carriers, and it's one of Breeze's operating bases. It's also the only commercial airport in Rhode Island with flights outside the state. The other two, Westerly and Block Island, only have flights to each other. Breeze has been flying here since its start of operations in 2021, and it currently connects Rhode Island to 12 regular destinations along with 5 seasonal ones. Of course, some of these don't run daily. Pittsburgh flights only depart 5 days a week, for example. Our plane today would be an Embraer E195, one of 6 in Breeze's fleet. I would be flying an economy, which on Breeze is marked out with yellow-trimmed seats. Extra legroom seats get red trim. The airline also has a first-class product, but that's only available on their Airbus A220 fleet. Stay tuned to the end to find out how much I paid for my trip. My seat came with 31 inches of pitch and 17.6 inches of width. There was a seat back safety information card and buy onboard menu, along with a tray table and space to mount a phone or tablet. Soon we were pushing back and heading to the runway, taking off into an absolutely breathtaking golden hour over our nation's smallest state. If you're enjoying this video, please consider subscribing for more trip reports and educational content about trains, planes, and transit. Breeze Airways was founded in 2018 under the name Moxie Airways by David Neeleman, an airline juggernaut who previously helped found JetBlue and WestJet. Neeleman still serves as the airline's CEO today. As of May 2024, Breeze flies 40 aircraft to 56 destinations, and they're still growing, with plans to expand to new markets this year, including my childhood home city of Lancaster, Pennsylvania? The Lancaster with an airport that looks like this, and flights that look like this? Let me know if you guys would like to see that when it launches. Service on board Breeze was a bit bare bones. There was a water service, but nothing else was offered, at least for free. By comparison, Delta and JetBlue usually have a complimentary drink and snack service on their Boston to Pittsburgh routes. In-flight entertainment was available for me to stream on my phone, but there was no in-flight Wi-Fi even to purchase. Delta offers this for a fee, and JetBlue's is free for all customers. So what did I pay for this trip? Well, my base fare was $109, with another $10 for seat selection and $37 for my carry-on. Taking the commuter rail and RIPTA bus was another $12. Thus, in total, I paid $168 for my trip. By comparison, on the day I booked, Delta was offering a morning flight on the same day for $149, and an afternoon flight for $179. Breeze has various fare classes, including Nice, Nicer, and Nicest, which come with various perks, including the ability to change your flight, extra legroom, etc. More information about this can be found on their website. All in all, my trip showed me that Breeze's unique value proposition lies mainly in its routes. It wasn't particularly worth traveling south from Boston for, it cost roughly the same as flying directly out of Logan Airport, and came with a bunch of extra hassle and marginally less onboard services. But let's say I was staying in Providence or southern Massachusetts. Then the prospect of flying out of a small, no-stress airport near me for an affordable fare would be a lot more appealing than trekking into Boston. And from where I live in Pittsburgh, Breeze is often my only go-to option if I ever want to travel somewhere like Norfolk or Charleston, where our plane was heading next, and I'd happily fly them again if the prices were good. In short, Breeze is absolutely worth it if the unusual routes they serve are convenient for you. Which is kind of the whole point.
It's like the beverages here are no longer extant.
No, they're here, hang on.
What is that?
I don't know why.
It's probably contaminated with who knows what.
So as you may recall, if you're a longtime viewer of this channel, Miles told me that if both escalators at South Station were working, which they are, he would change his name to Escalator. Here to comment is Miles.
Let's check back in 6 months. These have been popping up everywhere.
Apparently, how parade New England? It's a Jimmy Fund thing. That's actually really cool. It's like a cancer thing. Cancer is bad.
We just passed the foam viaduct.
Yeah, it was built like a really long time ago. It's so long ago.
So they have coffee syrup in the train station.
I don't know what coffee syrup is.
Our plane today would be an Embraer
E190. The real question is, since you can buy coffee milk in the train station, can you buy it in the airport? Yes, you can. You can actually buy multiple brands. Oh my gosh. Pawtucket Central Falls, my first time stopping here. It's a station with a platform. Very interesting.
How does it feel?
To be on your own with no direction.
I'm not doing any more Bob Dylan.
If you'd like to see more of me and Miles together, check out my Patreon, where we recently reacted to our first video together. Link in the description.